What's up? It's Patrick from Guy in the Cube, and in this video, I'm going to talk about custom partitions. Why do you need custom partitions, or why would you create them? Most importantly, how would you create them? Stay tuned. If you find this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam and this guy. All right, custom partitions. We're recently doing a live stream and Laura Graham Brown asked us, hey, how do you create custom partitions? But wait. More importantly, why would you create custom partitions? There's a couple of reasons. And let's say you have a fact table. That's what the table you want to partition up. You want to break it up. If there's a date there, which is probably the most common way you would partition your table up, you can use incremental refresh. And incremental refresh will create those partitions. It'll create daily partitions, monthly partitions, quarterly partitions, yearly partitions. But it's going to be based on your incremental refresh policy. But what if you don't have a date and you still want to create some partitions? Then you can actually create those custom partitions. That's one reason. Another reason is, and when we're talking about this on this live stream, and Adam brought this up, which is a really good point, you want to align those partitions with the partitions in your underlying source. Let's say you were using SQL or Synapse and you partition your data a certain way. Maybe you want to align those partitions in your Power BI dataset with those underlying partitions. Yeah, it's a possibility. Or you maybe want to create partitions because now you can scale out. You can have multiple queries running against this very large table. And so you can have them running in parallel, which could help your refreshes. You know, maybe you want to do something like that. So that's why you would create these partitions. And this is leading me to another point. You need premium or premium per user to create these custom partitions. But how do you create them? Well, that's what I'm going to show you. So you guys know what I like to do. Enough of all this talking. Let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. Okay. Let's say you have a model like this. And there's no date in my large fact table. And so I want to partition it by sales territory, country. You can go here, go to external tools and launch Tableau Editor. It's going to open up, connect it to the model locally, and I guarantee you so many people will be tempted to do this. And then you'll have this partition and you can come here and say, Hey, I'm going to, it's not working. And I really like this feature because you should not try to create partitions against the local model. Because if you decide that you want to enable incremental refresh, you do get a date, guess what's going to happen to your custom partitions? Power BI is going to step all over them and kick them out and create its own partition. So you need to deploy the model out, connect to the model with Tableau Editor via your XMLA endpoint and start creating your partitions. Let me show you. So instead of doing this, close it, open up another Tableau Editor, connect to the model from the database, go ahead and put your XMLA endpoint and click OK. So once you get this prompt right here, go ahead and authenticate, and then it's going to give you a list of databases. I'm going to do territory, no partitions, pretty obvious that there's no partitions there. And what I'm going to do is find the table, which will be my internet sales table, expand it and expand partitions. And you'll see by default, there's one there. I'm going to rename this partition because this is going to be my first partition. I'm going to call it United States. And then you can start writing the M to add your filter onto this. I'm not going to write any M because I'm not lazy. I'm just really efficient. I'm going to pop back over to Power BI Desktop and go into the query editor. So we're going to go transform. I want to create a partition for each one of the countries. And so Canada is 6, the sales territory ID is 6, for France is 7, the United States is less than or equal to 5. So what I'm going to do is head back over to internet sales, create a filter, let Power Query do what it does. Great. Less than or equal to 5. Click OK. Now, it's very important. You want to make sure that this folds back. So right click, boom. So it's going to fold back. It's going to create the query for me. I'm just going to copy this line right here. I'm going to head back over to Tableau Editor. I created this new line. I'm going to call this partition filter. And then I'm just going to paste. And then copy this entire query. And then I'll create another partition. Let's say I do the one for Australia. Right click, create new partition. Paste the code in. Get rid of 5, make it 9, and then I'm going to go over here and type internet sales dash Australia. And then I'll repeat the step until I've created all the partitions. And like a cooking show, bam, I've created all my partitions. So you can see I have one for Australia, one for Canada. I'm just varying the sales territory key that's on my fact table. And basically what's going to happen is when I refresh this, depending on the capacity or the gateway, whatever you're doing, how many containers you have, it will run that number of queries for this particular table when it's available. And maybe your refresh will be faster. Remember I said you need to make sure it folds, because if it doesn't fold, What it's going to do is it'll send a select from your very large fact table equal to the number of partitions. So it's going to send that query the same number of times that you have those partitions, and the filter won't be there. So if you have a billion row table and that query doesn't fold that filter back, it's going to run that query. In my case, I have 7 partitions. It's going to run that query 7 times, returning a billion rows, and you may get a timeout. So let me show you what the end result looks like. So after you do all this and create your partitions, you click save, then you do a refresh on your data set. And then if you head over to SSMS and you connect to the model, so you just choose connect, choose analysis services, pop in your endpoint, authenticate, find that particular database. I already have one. I call it partitions. It should have been partitions. But anyway, right click on it, choose partitions. This window will pop up and you can see how many rows are in each partition, which should equal to, if you go back to my desktop file that I created, I did a count rows here, and you can see the United States, there's 219,595 rows. And if you go look at your partitions here, you'll see it's the exact same amount. And that's how you do it. It's not that difficult. You just need to make sure you have premium per user or premium, and you can't do it against your local desktop file. You'll have to connect via the XML endpoint to create your partitions. All right, what do you think? Have you tried to create custom partitions? Do you happen to need a need for it? Well, I suggest you go out and kick the tires, test it out, do a baseline on your refreshes to make sure it's not slowing things down, and hopefully it's speeding things up. If you have any questions, comments, you know what to do. Post them in the comments below. If it's your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button. If you like my video, big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.